Welcome to the next session of Harbor Engineering. We are continuing with chapter number 4, which is the most important chapter in the syllabus of Harbor Engineering. So now let's begin with this new session with the new topics. So the first topic which we are going to study in today's session is jetty. Jetty, already we have come across this word while we have studied the harbor components in chapter number 2. So let us revise few of the features. And then we will be discussing in detail about this harbor component. So first of all, it is an narrow structure that is with a nominal width projecting from shore into water with bulwarks on one or both sides. So basically it is projecting from the shore into the water and having berthing facility on both the sides and very rarely on the end portion. Mostly here the berthing is done on both the sides, or when the ship traffic is less on a single side, it is very rare case that we berth or we tie up the ship across the width of the jetty. So that is first point. Another thing which we are aware about jetty is that it is perpendicular or inclined to the shore, and basically it is used for handling the petroleum products. That is crude oil or various low cargo petroleum products. It is in form of piled projection, that is end bearing piles are used. We will be learning about this in the upcoming slides in further detail. Constructed outside the harbor or inside the harbor, basically as we have seen that while we have studied the topic of harbor components, we have seen figures in which jetty was placed outside the harbor. And moreover, while we were studying the artificial harbor drawing, we have studied that jetty was placed inside the harbor. So there is no such rule as to jetty should be placed outside only or inside only. It can be placed as per the demand of the situation. When built in combination with breakwater, it is termed as breakwater pier. That is, whenever it is placed adjacent or in contact with breakwater, then it is termed as breakwater pier. Why? Because pier and jetty, we know that similarity is in the purpose, that is both carry out the loading and unloading operation. Both are perpendicular or inclined, and the difference is that in handling the amount of cargo or commodity. Jetty basically handles low weight cargo or commodity. So whenever it is in combination with breakwater, it is termed as breakwater pier. Now the uses of jetty. So the first point is in providing the berthing. We are already aware about this point, that is berthing can be provided on both the sides or if needed on single side only. Next, it is used for handling inflammable materials, that is petrol, diesel, kerosene or crude oil. So basically for handling of petroleum products, jetty is used. It can be used for dredging in the approach channel as well. Now basically when we are carrying out the dredging operation, that is while we are removing the excessive sediment deposits from the seabed, the dredger can be placed on the jetty and the dredging operation can be carried out. So if we want to carry out the dredging specifically in the approach channel, so if jetty is placed adjacent to the entrance channel as we have seen in the figure of harbor components, the jetty was placed adjacent to the approach channel. So in that situation, the dredger can be placed on the jetty. And after that, by the use of dredgers, the dredging operation, that is excavation operation, removal of sediments from the seabed can be carried out. Next are the types of jetties. So basically first is the piled structure. Pile, we know that basically here it will be an end bearing pile which will be transferring the load from top to the seabed or the bottom. So basically pile structure, that is it might be vertical structure or inclined structure, that is struts. Open pile jetty. Now here as we can see that the word open has been used. The reason being that whenever these piles are constructed, there is existence of gap or space amongst the piles. So as we can see that whenever piles are constructed, they are not a continuous structure, they are not a through structure. So there will be existence of gap or space amongst the piles. So that is the reason for using the word open. So let's talk further in brief. It can't be used where jetty is required to be very wide. Now basically when the jetty is very wide. The reason for the width of jetty being more is that it will be handling heavy weight cargo or more than moderate weight cargo or commodity. So basically, whenever we are using the pile structure, it can carry a bit up to nominal load. So when the cargo or commodity to be carried is very high, that is the width which will be needed will also be more. And basically, in that situation, we can't construct this pile jetty. We might have to move towards a solid type jetty in which there is sort of a granular filling being done beneath the platform. So there will be a limitation in case of pile jetty regarding the width. The reason being that is the amount of cargo or commodity which it can handle, which is up to a certain extent, up to a certain limit only. It is generally made up of timber, RCC or steel. So mostly timber is used, but even that is cement concrete can be used, which is reinforced, and even steel sections can be used instead of the timber section. Next up is the image for timber jetty. Basically, it is a wooden construction, and here various wooden members have been shown. First of all, this is the end bearing pile. These are the piles. Next, the diagonal members, that is the inclined members, are struts, while these the horizontal member are runners. So the horizontal members which have been shown here are runners. Vertical members are the piles, which are the end bearing piles, and the inclined members are struts. Moreover, this is the platform which is for the movement of cargo, commodity or human activity. So there is a sort of gap between the platform and the runner, but there is no such any specific importance regarding it. The platform can also be kept in touch or can also be kept directly above the runner. So here sort of gap has been shown. Also, this is the slope, that is the existing seabed, and the water level has been shown. So basically, this is sort of, we can say, a jetty which will be handling a sort of nominal weight, nominal or moderate cargo commodity can be carried, and the various wooden members have been shown here. Moreover, there will also be connection between these members, that is whenever the members are meeting, at that point there can be bolted connection, there can be bracings or lacings, so that the wooden structure remains stable. Basically, the reason for providing bracings, that is sort of tying up or bolted connection, can be done, which will increase the stability of the structure as a whole. And this is the water level which has been shown. Next, in types of jetties, the pile structure, in which we will be talking about now, pile and cylinder jetties. So here, as we can see, the casing of piles have been done. Casing means this is sort of a cylindrical structure which is covering the jetty. And the reason for providing this casing is to make sure that the deterioration of pile does not take place easily, its durability increases, and the maintenance needed for it reduces. So basically, sort of this casing has been done around the jetties for protecting the jetty, that is from deteriorating its characteristics, from sort of increasing its durability, and also decreasing the maintenance, to make sure that for a long period of time the strength of the jetty remains as it is. So this is the casing. Piles are completely encased in concrete cylinders. This sort of concrete cylinders are constructed on the circumference or periphery, which will encase, that is, which will be sort of providing a covering to the existing piles. Piles carry the loads of whole structure. So basically, here the casing has been provided, but the transfer of load from the top takes place through these piles to the sea bed. The casing will not carry any load. Repeating again, the load which is acting on the platform, dead load or live load or self weight, that will pass through the piles to the seabed. The casing will not take any load. Capable of sustaining heavy impacts from ships. Now, another simple point here is that as we are providing the casing, the sustainability, that is its capacity to take impact load, will increase, because instead of casing only if the jetty are existing as they are due to the impact of ship, there might be a possibility of damage to the piles. So the heavy impacts, wherever there will be the sort of, we will be using the heavy ship or will be handling the heavy ship, in that situation this casing will come into picture. It will be advantageous as it will be able to take the heavy impact of ship. Next harbor component now are piers. So first of all, we have completed jetty. Now we will be learning about piers. So basically pier, what all we already are aware about is that it is a loading unloading platform or marine terminal structure. It is perpendicular or inclined to the shore, and basically here the berthing operation can be done on both the sides. So piers are structure built at an angle with the shore, that is, it might be inclined, not necessarily inclined, but it can be perpendicular as well, that is making 90 degrees. On both sides of a pier, berths are provided. So as it is perpendicular or inclined, on both the sides we can carry out the berthing operation. Open construction, as I previously said, the word open is used in that situation where the end bearing piles are used as there is existence of space or gap. So the open construction basically indicates that end bearing piles have been used for transferring the load from the platform to the seabed and there is existence of space or gap amongst them. Open pier are constructed over open water on exposed timber or concrete piles. So basically this is a timber construction or concrete piles can be used. Even in certain situation where needed, casing can be done, as we have seen in the case of jetty. So basically timber piles are used, even concrete piles can be used in a situation where it demands, and also the casing of the timber piles can be done by use of concrete, as we have seen in an example of jetty. Next, again continuing with piers, that this is an image of the structure which is perpendicular to the shore. Again, this is a open type construction. If we talk about solid piers, basically they are built of materials like earth or rock fill. So instead of this open construction, beneath the platform there is continuous filling of earth or rocks or granules. So it is a solid construction, that is a through construction, and there is no existence of any gap or space. So the solid piers, repeating again, consist of earth or rock fill, that is beneath the platform. It is a through structure. There is no any existence of gap, as is the case in the case of the open construction. It offers more resistance, that is an obvious point, to impact and wave action. Why? Because if we construct a granule construction, that is, if we make a through construction in which the soil or granules have been filled, it will have more resistance to the impact rather than this piles. So basically it will offer more resistance, that is solid piers will offer more resistance to the impact of the ship. And when we are constructing the open type piers, as I told previously, that it will be able to handle the impact load up to a certain limit only. More stable than open pier. So this is also a self understood point, that as the construction is through, it will be able to resist more force. So the stability of the solid pier will be more than open pier. No provision is made for cargo storage. Why? Because basically it is a loading unloading platform, and from that platform the cargo or commodity are transferred towards the storage terminal facility, that is transit shed or warehouse. So specifically there is no provision of cargo storage on the pier itself, but the transit shed, that is the storage terminal facility for temporary storage of cargo, is kept adjacent or in the vicinity to the pier, so that the cargo or commodity which is unloaded can be transferred as soon as possible to the transit shed. Next are the arrangement of piers. So basically this is a view for three piers which have been shown. This is the shoreline. So the pier here are shown perpendicular to the shoreline, and here, as we can see, that the berthing operation can be done on both the sides and also on single side. So pier which is perpendicular to the shoreline, and basically berthing on both the sides, or as in the case that is for the first and third pier, the berthing can be done on single side as well. Next, now this is an image for two berth pier. The reason is that as one ship is in this direction and the another ship is in the opposite direction, so here as the two ships are berthed simultaneously, so the name is two berth pier. So let's talk about the labels in this figure. First of all, pier, that is the perpendicular structure perpendicular to the shoreline. Transit shed, that is the storage facility which is kept adjacent or in the vicinity of the loading unloading platform. So as soon as the cargo or commodity is unloaded, it can be transferred to the transit shed. So this is the storage facility for short term storage. Ship have been shown which are berthed. The operation for this berthing, basically berth means to provide accommodation. So first of all, the ship is allowed to enter into the harbor, then its space or accommodation is decided. So it is given the specific length or the specific space which it will accommodate, and then it is tied up or given anchorage with the mooring accessories. Mooring accessories we will be learning. That is basically mooring accessories are those accessories which can be used for tying up of the ship. So first of all, the ship enters the harbor, it is given the space for accommodation, then it is tied up with the mooring accessory. So berthing is in general terms giving accommodation or space. So here the beam has been shown. Beam means the width of the ship, and slip indicates the gap between two ships. So slip is basically the transverse gap between two ships, which is nearly three times the beam. So the 3 to 4 times the beam or width of ship is slip. And one last point is that while deciding the width, while deciding the slip, we have to keep the width of the widest ship which is going to visit the harbor. So whenever that widest ship is visiting, which will be in a certain interval, so we have to make sure that there is sort of no any hindrance to the operations of the other ship which are going on in the harbor area. Next is the four berth pier. So we have seen the figure of two berth pier. This is a four berth pier. As we can see, four ship have been placed. So the labels are nearly same. That is beam width of ship. Slip indicates the clearance in the transverse direction, which is 3 to 4 times the width of the ship. Pier, that is the perpendicular structure. Transit shed, that is for the short term storage, which is placed adjacent or in vicinity to the loading unloading platform. And the name has been given because four ship have been berthed. So basically, whenever we are talking about pier, we have to see the direction of the berthing. That is, here as we can see that berthing has been done in both the directions. Ship, the count of ship will vary, because if the dimension of ship is more, then we will be berthing less amount of ships, and if the dimension of ship is less, then we will be able to berth more amount of ships. So basically, more important thing is that we can berth in both the direction in pier and jetty, while we can only berth in one direction in case of wharf and quay, which we have seen. Next component is a pier head. So pier head basically is placed on the breakwater, and generally it exists on the entrance channel, and it is provided with a lighting facility. So it is sort of a fixed navigational aid, like lighthouse. Lighthouse is also a fixed navigational aid. Fixed means that its position is fixed, it is not floating, and generally it is very small as compared to the dimension of lighthouse, but the purpose of both are same. Basically, they guide to the navigator while he is moving as to what is the entrance of the harbor. That is the purpose of pier head. So pier head is a structure constructed at the tip of the breakwater, that is at the end point of breakwater, near the harbor entrance. So generally they are placed at the harbor entrance, and basically they give the idea as to from where is the entrance to the harbor. It helps in demarcating clearly the approach channel. So as we will be able to demarcate from the existence or from the light of the pier head as to where clearly the approach channel to the harbor is. So that's it for this session. In this session, we have learned in detail regarding jetty. We have learned about piers, and lastly, we have seen pier head. So we will continue with the upcoming new topics in the next session.